Hi everyone, welcome to Nagharisha Indian Food Recipes. Today I am going to share you a famous and traditional South Indian Pal Thalikulu or Thalikale Payasam. We make this on any festive or special occasions. Generally, these Pal Thalikulu are offered as Naivedyam or Prasadam to Lord Ganesh on Ganesh Chaturthi. There are many variations of making these Pal Thalikulu and today I am going to share you an easy method in a simple process. So let us see the ingredients to prepare this Pal Thalikulu. Few pistachios, few raisins, 6 cashews, few strands of saffron, this is complete optional, small size sago, 1 tablespoon, or even you can use large sago or sagabiyam of your choice. But when you are using this, you have to soak in 2 tablespoons of water for half an hour. Here I am going to use small sago, 1/2 cup shredded jaggery or adjust according to your taste, 1/2 teaspoon cardamom powder, 3 tablespoons ghee, a pinch of baking soda, 2 tablespoons sugar, homemade rice flour 1 cup, whole milk or reduced fat milk 5 cups, and also we require 1 jenthakulu mold or murukku presser. Here I am going to use this round shaped plate. Now let's start the process to make this Pal Thalikulu. First I am going to share you how to make rice flour at home. For this, wash and soak 2 cups of rice for 2 to 3 hours. Spread the rice on a clean cloth and fan dry until there is no wet in rice. Now by using mixy jar, grind it into fine powder and sieve the flour. Now separate coarse rice rava into another plate. Here by using this coarse rice rava, we can make it into undralu or kudumulu, or even you can make it into fine powder of your choice. Here by using this rice flour, I am going to prepare Pal Thalikulu. You can even store this rice flour or rice rava up to a month or two by refrigerating in a Ziploc bag. Now let's start to make Pal Thalikulu. Heat 2 tablespoons of ghee in a heavy bottom non-stick pan on a medium heat. Once the ghee is enough hot, add cashews, pistachios and saute it well until light golden color. When the cashews are turning to golden color, add raisins and saute it well until the raisins are puffed up or for few seconds. Now transfer to the other plate. Now into the same pan add milk, sago or sagabiyam. Mix it once completely, cover it and bring it to a boil. And also stir in between to prevent sticking at the bottom. And in the meanwhile, let's make the rice flour dough. For this, first melt a tablespoon of jaggery by adding 3 to 4 tablespoons of hot water or milk. Strain it by using tea strainer, set this aside. Into homemade rice flour, add baking soda and a teaspoon of ghee. Mix it well completely and make sure there is no lumps. Now slowly add melted jaggery into rice flour mixture and make it into soft chapati dough. Here instead of melted jaggery, sugar can be replaced too. Now smear some ghee and set this aside. On the other side, milk starts to boil and sago is turning to transparent. Now turn the flame to as low as possible and add the dough into jenthakulu mold. Here when you press the mold, the dough should come out easily. Now press the jenthakulu mold and drop into milk in a circular motion for one time. Do not put any ladle immediately. Cover it and let it boil for 2 minutes, otherwise the noodles may break. And after 2 minutes, gently mix it once, otherwise it will not retain their shape. Now again, press the jenthakulu mold and drop into milk in a circular motion for second time. Do it in a similar way until the dough is completed and make sure to cook this on a very low flame. Now cover this and cook for 15 minutes on a very low flame. Here you can see the rice noodles are cooked well. And once they are done, it will float in milk. Here whenever the milk is combined with jaggery, it will curdle. So to prevent from that, while making the dough, I used baking soda. Now gently mix it once completely. Now to this add sugar, cardamom powder, few strands of saffron, and this is complete optional. Now gently mix it once and allow the sugar to melt completely. Now turn off the flame, wait for a minute and add shredded jaggery. If you feel the jaggery is having any impurities, you can even add melted jaggery. Or instead of jaggery, sugar can be replaced too. But traditionally, we add jaggery. Now gently mix it once completely until the jaggery is well combined. Here our traditional palathalikilu or thalikile paisam is ready now. Transfer this into a bowl and garnish with roasted nuts. Offer this to God as naivedyam or prasadam to Lord Ganesh on Ganesh Chaturthi. Try making this recipe at your home. And if you like this recipe, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel Nagharisha Indian Food Recipes and thumbs up this video. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon with another new delightful recipe. Until then, bye.